about you.
Good morning. We had a little mix-up this morning, and I was live too early. So if you were on then, I hope you're coming back on now. It is a wonderful day in Johnstown, and we are pleased to be here. I'm sitting in my office, and I have with me Kylie Taylor, who is our technical person, and Pastor Deb Greger, who is here but not on camera, but you're going to hear her voice shortly. I just have a couple announcements. I want to thank everybody for everything that they did to get the church conference over with. It is done for a year. Alleluia. I also want to thank the people from Homestead and everyone who supported them last night for their Swiss steak drive-through dinner. They were sold out by 2:30, and they didn't start till 4 o'clock, so it was a good time. And a fellowship and working together, and I thank everyone who took part of that. I'm also just putting the word out there that Grove Avenue needs 2 trustees for the coming year. So if God's going to lay that on your heart, answer that call, please. So, but we are glad you're with us, and we thank you for being here today. And Deb, do you want to say anything from the voice from the other side of the room?
Good morning, everybody.
Today, the service is going to be different than what we've ever done before. And this is like technically challenging me, so kind of bear with us too with this. But today's service is a contemplative healing service, and I had hoped to have this last week. This year has been a crazy year. With our COVID, with the political drama and divisions within our country, and then just our own personal healing needs. I think we, as a community of faith, stand in need of healing. So today's service will be different. It may be a little uncomfortable because it's unfamiliar. I'm going to give you some questions after scripture reading, and you're going to have a little bit of time to ponder those questions. But I would ask that you just be open to the Spirit of God moving within us and among us this morning. And don't worry, if you don't like this style of worship, next week we go back to normal. So just enjoy today. Yeah, God, our God, made the universe, and He waits to embrace us. So here and now, we come to feel God's healing touch upon us. We come with all that we are, parts that are whole, parts that are broken, parts that are well, parts that are sick, parts that are joyful, and parts that are in pain. With all that we are, we come to worship and find our rest in our gracious and merciful and loving God. Today, we're going to be worshiping God through prayers and music and scripture, and through periods of silence. Silence when we listen to that still small voice of God. In normal times, if we were doing a healing service, there would be communion and anointing. Well, we can't do that, but that's all part of the healing process also. But God is our source of all life, all wholeness, and we as a community of faith are called into the presence of the Holy One. And as we calm our minds and make ourselves more present to God, we wait. And we breathe in the very presence of God, and we let go of our, as we breathe out, we let go of our frustrations and our worries and our cares. And we breathe in the presence of God, and we breathe out and let go of everything that's keeping us from focusing on God. And as we let go of those things that bind us, as we let go of those things that separate us from God and from others, we enter into a freedom that Christ offers us. Our prelude this morning is
Turn Your Eyes Upon
Jesus. So prepare your hearts for it.
God of life,
you are as near to us as our breath.
Touch our eyes,
that we may see you.
Open our ears,
that we may hear your voice.
Enter our hearts,
that we may know your love.
Grace our souls and our bodies with your presence,
that we might feel your strength and your healing touch. Come, God of breath and wholeness, in the name of Jesus Christ, amen. Let us pray. O Lord, you are the healer of all our ills. You are the great physician. We bring to you, Lord, our bodies, minds, and spirits, hurting and broken by the violence, ills, trauma, and cares of a world separated from you. Come to us now with your healing powers.
Breathe on me, breath of God, and make me whole.
O God, we ask that you heal us. Give us the strength, health, wisdom, and knowledge only found through you. Send your life-giving spirit so that we may live our lives with courage in the peace of your love. Come to us now with your healing powers.
Breathe on me, breath of God, and make me whole.
O God, we ask that you sustain those who seek to alleviate the pain and suffering of this world. Send your life-giving spirit to bring healing and promote health. Come to us now with your healing powers.
Breathe on me, breath of God, and make me whole.
Send your life-giving spirit to heal the wounds of societies and nations, so that we may promote your love and grace, bringing healing to those in conflict and stability to those who are vulnerable. Come to us now with your healing powers.
Breathe on me, breath of God, and make me whole. As you listen to this hymn, it's a time to pray and to be still and to reflect and just to be open what God is saying to you now. Breathe on me, breath of God.
Healing was central to Jesus' ministry. Healing was central to Jesus' ministry. Healing is a sign of God's kingdom, and it brings renewal and wholeness of life to those who turn to God in their need. In every act of worship, the church celebrates the grace of God, who desires all of us, all people, to have wholeness of body, mind, and spirit. Today we focus on that healing characteristic of God. We bring to God our own frailty and brokenness, felt not only as physical illness, but also as guilt, anxiety, and burdens that weigh us down. We also bring our concerns for others and for the world. Above all, we come to God, who knows our needs before we ask and whose love is revealed in and through Jesus Christ. God has provided us with spiritual tools, and one of those tools is prayer, persistent prayer, persevering prayer, hopeful prayer, waiting prayer. This morning, we wait. We wait with open hearts and an open mind to receive whatever the Spirit has for us. We wait in the face of suffering and injustice. We wait in the face of neglect and rejection. We wait in the face of trials and adversities. We wait for God's kingdom to come to earth. We wait in hope and faith.
Paul writes in his letter to the Philippians, "Christ is stronger than suffering and death. Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your requests to God, and the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus."
The Lord summons us to look beyond the merely physical aspects of our lives, to see deeper into the mystical and the truer meaning of all things. I offer you some questions. We're going to take a moment and reflect on these questions. What are you anxious about? How would it feel to release your burden? To release your burden to the Lord. What would it look like if you could lift up your anxiety with thanksgiving in the midst of turmoil, in the midst of everything that's going on today? What are you thankful for? Imagine presenting your fears and your concerns to the Lord, sharing your truest desires, your fears, your dreams, your hopes. Thank you.
Jesus said, "Come to me, all you who are struggling hard and carrying heavy loads, and I will give you rest. Put on my yoke and learn from me. I'm gentle and humble, and you will find rest for yourselves. My yoke is easy to bear, and my burden is light." Jesus always brought and always brings healing to wherever there is brokenness. Confession and assurance are needed because we are broken people of body, mind, and spirit, longing for God's wholeness and reconciliation. As a broken people who seek healing, let us pray to God. Out of the depths of despair, we cry to you, O God. We are lost in a world of pain and suffering. When we put our trust in weapons of war, we find no peace. When we put our faith in our own resources, we feel the ache of our true needs. When we put our hope in the health of our bodies, we suffer pain and find no healing. Come to us, O God. Forgive our doubts and fears. Heal our brokenness, that we may rejoice in your steadfast love. Amen. There is forgiveness and healing with God. God's steadfast love has the power to redeem our brokenness and make us whole. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. This scripture is another way to find God's peace. Is any one of you in trouble? They should pray. Is anyone happy? Let them sing songs of praise. Is any one of you sick? They should call the elders of the church to pray over them and anoint them with oil in the name of the Lord. And the prayer offered in faith will make the sick person well. The Lord will raise them up. If they have sinned, they will be forgiven. Therefore, confess your sins to each other and pray for each other so that you may be healed. The prayer of a righteous person is powerful and effective.
Based on this scripture, I invite you to think about these questions, to reflect on them. Imagine presenting your fears and concerns to the Lord. Share with the Lord your truest desires. Who have you asked to pray for you? Who can you ask? Who in your circle of friends and acquaintances can you ask to pray for you? Who are you praying for right now in your prayer life? Whose name do you frequently lift before the Lord? Who is God calling you to begin to pray for that person?
Lord, send your
Hear now these words, this powerful story from the Gospel of Mark. They spent some time in Jericho. As Jesus was leaving town, trailed by his disciples and a parade of people, a blind beggar by the name of Bartimaeus, son of Timaeus, was sitting alongside the road. When he heard that Jesus, the Nazarene, was passing by, he began to cry out, "Son of David, Jesus, mercy, have mercy on me." Many tried to hush him up, but he yelled all the louder, "Son of David, mercy, have mercy on me." Jesus stopped in his tracks. "Call him over." They called him. "It's your lucky day. Get up. He's calling you to come." Throwing off his coat, he was on his feet at once and came to Jesus. Jesus said, "What can I do for you?" The blind man said, "Rabbi, I want to see." "On your way," said Jesus. "Your faith has saved and healed you." And in that very instant, he recovered his sight and followed Jesus down the road.
In this story, Jesus called out to Bartimaeus. Imagine that Jesus is calling you. What is he saying? Bartimaeus took off his coat and threw it on the ground as he went to Jesus. What do you need to throw down? What do you need to lay aside to be more present to Jesus? Jesus asked Bartimaeus, "What can I do for you?" And Bartimaeus said, "I want to see." Jesus is asking you, "What can I do for you?" How do you want Jesus to show mercy on you? Who is Jesus calling you to show mercy towards?
For blessings, we pray for peace, comfort for family, protection while we sleep. We pray for healing, for prosperity. We pray for your mighty hand to ease our suffering. And all what you hear each spoken need, yet love us way too much to give us lesser things. 'Cause what if your blessings come through raindrops? What if your healing comes through tears? What if a thousand sleepless nights are face in disguise.
Today, I hope you've had time to reflect on not only what your needs and desires are, but what the Lord is calling you to do. This is a time now where we lift up our joys and our concerns. And today, we're lifting up Linda and Bonnie and Bev and Seth. Prayers for my mom's friend. Thanksgiving for daughter's care and wisdom. The ending of this political election, and hopefully the end of the unrest. Prayers for students and teachers and healthcare workers, for Pastor Deb and Karen and the Taylor family. And I have a joy today. Today would have been my wonderful husband's 64th birthday. And today I thank God for the gift of him. And I also had the opportunity to see two sets of kids this week that I don't normally get to see. So I'm lifting up Jenna and Alex and Hillary and Brady. We're also lifting up prayers for Morgan and Nancy. So please, let's turn our hearts again to the Lord. Oh Lord, today we come seeking restoration and healing for ourselves, for our loved ones, for this community, for our nation, and for the world. Oh, the needs are so much. But like the song reminded us, we have so many blessings, and we thank you for those blessings that you've given us. We thank you for how you're constantly at work in our lives. You, Lord, you are our help in times of difficulty. You are our strength in times of weakness. You are our guide when we feel lost and alone. You have the power to transform us, to transform this world. You can mend broken relationships. You can bring strength to the weary and hope to the brokenhearted. And so we come. We come and we bring our worries and our burdens, our hopes and our dreams, our pain and our tears. We bring them with us and we lay them before you, knowing that you are the God of our lives. You are the God of hope for this world. Grant us your help, your guidance, and your support. Oh, today, Lord, we remember all those who are worried about their health and those who are anxious or depressed or afraid, or those who are in the hospital and those who are impacted by COVID. Those people who have burdens that they can't share with others, and so they carry them alone. We pray for those who mourn, for the loss of someone dear to their heart. And Lord, we pray for your church, not only here in Johnstown, but your church around the world. Merciful God, we pray for those who know your saving love, that we may be grateful, that we may share our faith by loving those that you put in our path, that we may use our gifts, the gifts that you've given us, to serve others and to bring glory to you. We hold before you the people and situations that you've placed on our hearts today. We lift up Linda and Bonnie and Bev and Seth and birthday prayers for a friend, that she could thank her daughter for her care and her wisdom. We thank you that the election is over, and Lord, we pray for your wisdom and discernment to be upon our governmental leaders. And we pray that we would become a nation united in spite of our differences, that we would be a nation where differences are appreciated. We pray for students and teachers and healthcare workers and all those who are impacted by the COVID. Health-wise and financially, we pray for the Taylor family and Pastor Deb and Karen. We lift up Morgan and Nancy. And Lord, we thank you for our family and friends who make our journey easy. And we thank you not only for our family and friends who are with us now, we thank you for those who are no longer with us and who dwell with you. Now, as we've offered prayers for these people and situations, help us to remember, Lord, that we stand in need of prayer. Prayers for healing and strength and encouragement and peace. And we ask these things in the name of Jesus as we continue to pray responsively. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name.
Mystery beyond our knowing, close to us as our breathing, in humble awe we pray.
Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
We pray for your vision of justice and mercy to be made real in our world even now.
Give us today our daily bread.
We pray for your vision of enough sustenance, enough warmth, enough healing for all of your children.
Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
We pray for the grace to let go of that which is death dealing, as we embrace your vision for life, that we might follow you safely through the obstacle course.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory is yours, now and forever.
Giving thanks for presence that defies definition in this life and beyond. Amen.
And amen. Our going out hymn is All to Jesus.
The summons.
It's the summons.
Turn and follow you and me.
close, we remember that we are healed by the love and the mercy of Jesus Christ, and we are called. We are called to hold this world that needs healing, not only in our prayers, but we are called to keep them in our hearts by serving. So touched by your grace,
we take your grace to the world.
Healed by your love,
we take your love to the world.
Renewed by your Spirit,
we go in the Spirit's power to be agents of your healing. Amen.
If you found freedom, take it with you into the world. If you have found comfort, go and share it with others. If you have dreamed dreams, help one another that they may come true. If you have known love, give some back to a bruised and hurting world. Go in peace. Amen, and have a blessed week, and know that you are loved.